Hey guys, this is the Gorkon Shuttle by 3 different people. And that's a lot of names. Alright, let me give you guys a quick walk around. Those are very small nacelles. So the Gorkon costs 5,428 PC with 1,367 blocks. Alright, let's see here. The exterior seems to be rather simple. I do like the shaping though. Nice texturing and modeling or shaping job on the nacelle as well. There is a single spotlight to the front of the vehicle. We get a nice big windshield as well. Same thing on the other side of the vehicle. I'm guessing this is the bay door button. To the top of the vehicle. That's very simple, but not bare bone. To the bottom of the vehicle. We get a single connector, a lot of upward thrusters, and some magnetic plates for landing gears with lights as well. You can probably also use the landing gears to, you know, carry and tow stuff around. This is a very nice texturing work, by the way. Alright, that's pretty much the whole exterior. Let's get inside now. A simple passenger cabin here with some information on the weather and the gravitational condition. Are this storage? Equipment containers. Those are a lot of tools. Light panels. Interesting flooring. So you can carry four passengers in here. Let's see what's in the bridge. Fancy Star Trek panels. I don't see any of the black tabs over them. More seats for passengers here. So in total, we can carry 6 passengers and a single co-pilot. Look at all those fancy panels though. Yeah, I think people should just replace all the, you know, information on their control seats LCD displays with these fancy panels. They look really cool. Federation. Alright, that's pretty much the whole interior. Hold on, let me close this here. We got some Federation citizens. Space. The final frontier. Some basic controls on the toolbar. A lot of basic controls on the toolbar. What the hell is this thing? Hatch timer. Emergency beacon. That's something that will always be turned on whenever I'm flying. Fly. The upward acceleration is not really that amazing. So you know, you probably shouldn't be carrying too much stuff in this thing. Forward acceleration is pretty acceptable. Backward acceleration is pretty acceptable as well. Side acceleration. Kind of feels too slow actually. That means we won't be able to tilt much in gravity. What the hell? Yeah, we're starting to fall easily. The rolling speed was a bit slow for a bit there. I'm not sure what happened. The turning speed of the vehicle is pretty decent though. Well, it's a pretty decent handling for a shuttle, and just gotta be careful when flying this thing. Let's say that we got into some kind of a temporal anomaly, and we met Da Vinci or something with his flying machine, but it failed. Let's see if the shuttle can help tow the vehicle. Oh, there you go. Yeah, this got some carrying capability, but you know, I still won't carry anything too heavy. What's the fuel in Star Trek again? Dilithium? I'm not sure. I forgot. But alright, let's say that we ran out of that fuel. Let's see how well this vehicle can go downhill. There goes the progress of aviation for like 100 years or something. Hold on. We're actually doing rather fine though. The bridge of the shuttle and the passenger area is actually, are actually rather well protected. What the hell? Spatial anomaly. Is this thing still flyable? Hold on. Oh, there goes the co-pilot seat though. Oh, there you go. It's still drivable. Flyable. Maximum impulse out of here, Anson. You know what they say about diplomacy. We are space NATO now. Alright. Let's see how well the shuttle can deal with a disguised Romulan outpost. here goes. We're kind of slow actually, but I'll try to dodge the enemy fire as much as possible. We do have enough firepower to disable all their weapons though, you know, in a timely manner. So even though the acceleration is, even though the acceleration is rather slow, we actually still have enough acceleration to be able to dodge most of the enemy firepower. It seems we're able to outturn the enemy, the enemy's artillery turret as well. Come on, fire. I want to disable their rocket turret at least. Come on. Stop firing at the what the hell? I think the artillery shell just bounced off the hull of the shuttle. Hold on. Yeah, this is too risky. I think I'm just gonna go under the enemy base. This is why you need a lot of firepower. By the way, what the hell? Well, hold on. Never mind. But the control seats got destroyed by that single artillery shot. And that was unfortunate. But yeah, well, for the PCU of the shuttle, you're definitely not getting that much, you know, practical function out of the shuttle. The door is broken, by the way. The shuttle does have quite a thick armor though, and you know, it's usable in all environments. So at least the shuttle has those advantage. I do wish the shuttle have like more performance and more functionalities though, like having a survival kit for example. But well, if you like the shuttle and PCU is not a problem or an issue for you, then this can be a good vehicle. So, that's the Gorkon Space Shuttle by these three people. You guys can find the link in the description below. Live long and prosper.